What's up, everyone? It's your boy, Jaquiel, your guide to living with Apple every day. And in this episode, I'm going to show you how to increase your iCloud storage size so you can fit more pictures, videos, content that you edit on CapCut, family pictures, photos, everything that you ever want, text messages, emails, etc. It's super quick, super simple. Without further ado, let's get started.
You go into settings. In settings, you want to actually click on your name at the top, and then you want to look for the iCloud tab. You click on that. You'll see something like this, like storage is used out of, but I've already paid for the 2 terabyte. I'm just showing you how to get there. You go to, you find something that's like iCloud Plus, or you look for something that's like manage plan. I've already paid for the 2 terabyte. Currently it's $10 a month, but if you need 6 terabyte or 12 terabyte, you just pay for more. There are downgrade options as well for you to go back down to the free version or cancel your iCloud Plus. Just to show you what the options are, you get free 5 gigabytes of iCloud with every iPhone. There's 50 gigabytes of iCloud storage for $1 per month and 200 gigabyte for $3 a month. However, if you're the type of person who already bought their iPhone for like 256 gigabytes like I did, and let's say you've already maxed out of 256 gigabytes with photos, videos, content that you create on CapCut, etc., or text messages, high attachment file, big attachment files in your email, etc., it doesn't make sense to pay for the 200 gigabyte plan for however many dollars a month, because you're still going to be missing out on 50 gigs worth of stuff that you want backed up, which is why the 2 terabyte plan is the least evil of the iCloud storages that actually make sense. Unless for some reason you went with an iPhone that only had like the 126 gigabyte, in which case the 200 gigabyte for only a couple bucks a month is twice the amount of storage that you have on your phone. So that would work, because then they upload basically all of 100 gigabytes or something like that, and then you still have a spare 100 gigabyte left. So after you pay for it, you can always downgrade back to the free version or back to smaller iCloud sizes if you find out that you didn't need all 2 terabytes. But because I record a lot of videos, a lot of photos, a lot of content, I'm already at almost like, I think, 400 or 500 gigabytes. So the 2 terabyte plan definitely makes sense. Let's say you have a lot of photos of your kid or videos, and you want them backed up in case your phone gets lost or broken. The 2 terabyte plan would also make sense. And then as your family grows over the years, and as you get more photos and videos, then upgrading to the other sizes would also make sense. Make sure you subscribe for more Apple tips.